Yes, I've been visiting her sister, Denicel, in her place. This place is, where is this, Jessa?
That's in, Barangay Sampaguita, Panela, Mandaue City.
Right. So, anything else you can say so we know where it is?
Yeah, that's the address in Mandaue. So, near in J Mall.
Thank you, that's what I wanted. So, yes, I've been going there because Denicel had a midwife going to massage Jessa, so she visited. Jessa at least got a little trip out of it. So here she stops along the main road and she's walking into her sister's place here. And in a while you're gonna see how Denicel and her family is living. It's Denicel, her man,
kids.
What's the name of him?
Jean-Marc.
Jean-Marc. And two kids, about 5, 6, 7 years old now.
Yeah.
So, it's a little bit away from the main road. And then in the end she comes in into where they actually live. They live so so close, yeah.
Yeah, so it's just a, what is this called? Urban?
Yeah. Place? This is kind of places that normal workers live, right?
Yeah, normal.
People working in factory or if they're working restaurant, bars, this would be around where they live, and the rent in these places is what, between 2,000 and 5,000 pesos?
Yeah, because it's only by room.
Yeah. So they live 4 people, 2 adults and 2 kids in a very, very small one-room apartment. Here we come. Oh yeah.
You see, it's a lot of something in places, a lot of selling different kinds of food.
Yeah, all these small shops. That's everywhere we go. They're along main roads, and they're in barangays like. This is not barangay, but I don't even know what to call this. This is like small communities within the city.
Yeah, I just said a small community.
Yeah. So
there is. So
if you compare it to Norway, you know, you have the city, and then outside of the city you have all these suburban areas. This would be the equal to that. Where all the workers live. Just in Norway they live in houses. Here they live like, yeah, you're gonna see.
Rooms?
I don't think a lot of foreign people go in these kind of places. I've been in here several times. I don't mind at all. We've been driving a motorbike in here, been walking in here. Every time been pretty safe for me.
Yeah, it's just you need to drive a little bit careful because a lot of kids around.
Yeah. But I never, in places like this, I never once felt unsafe or unwelcomed. If I were in, for example, Thailand, I would never go into an area like this.
But, in Thailand, we have still like that too.
Oh, yeah. But in Philippines, in general, I feel much, much safer, to be honest.
You see a lot of food in the corner?
Yeah. This food is really, really low cost.
Local food, and it tastes good.
It's fishes, chicken, pork.
Different.
And vegetables. Local barbecued and local style soups, right?
Yeah.
So here she comes in to
Near basketball court.
Yeah. Yeah, they have a basketball court in here that they have that most places in Philippines. Can't believe it. Philippine people love basketball. Must be because they're so tall. I have no other explanation. So if you would have gone to the right now, there's a very, very small alleys there. But Denicel lives up here. So she's almost at Denicel's place now, and you see the houses so close together.
Yeah.
The bad thing is if it gets a fire, like we seen in earlier video, an area like this and it gets fire and yeah, like 10 houses destroyed in one fire.
It's fast because it's what is this, a marine wood that
plywood and plywood. Marine plywood.
Easy to eat by the fire.
Yeah.
There's Jan motorbike.
Oh yeah, he lives there now.
No, visit.
Visit only. So.
That's Denisel's son.
Yeah. And this is where they live. And this is how normal people live in Philippines. This is normal life. We might be a little bit shocked, but this is normal. I told you to bring the flashlight, Jessa. It would have been good here.
Flashlight?
Yeah, the one
there. It's only there.
Yeah.
So there, this Jan.
Is the Janda sleeping there?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was somewhere.
It's
Jan. So that's her daughter and her son. And this is their whole place.
Actually,
now they have one more thing. They have a sofa that wasn't there when you were filming, right?
No, it's just arrived in the evening.
Yeah, so the sofa is probably there now?
Yeah, that's right.
So that is it. Denicel not happy with being filmed today. So this is where we're going now. Is this where they go for showering, cleaning, doing dishes and stuff? Or where is this place?
That's the place where another small community.
So just visiting another place.
Yeah.
So this is it. This is how Denicel and her little family lives. It's maybe humble, but they're happy.
Yeah, it's good. Happy there.
As long as happy, everything is good. So until next time, see you.